This is a T20 follow along kettlebell circuit. We're going to be doing 20 minutes of work with a kettlebell. A single kettlebell like this, just 8 kilos, is going to be enough to do this whole workout. If you've got heavier ones and you want to use those for some of the leg work, absolutely fine. If you've just got one, then you will be fine with me as well also. So we're going to warm up without it. We are then going to do into 30 seconds of effort for each exercise. There's going to be options to go harder or easier. So take those if you need it. Take breaks whenever you need it. And if you're not sure about taking part, you've got any injuries or anything you're not sure about, please get in touch before you start. Righto, let's do it. Kettlebell down, nice little bit of space for you to warm up. Let's give the legs a little roll and a little hip opener. So loosen up, lift and roll, nice and easy. So this is about you working through decent range of movement, decent effort level, finding a challenge with single arm work, single leg work, some core strengthening every time we use a single side with a kettlebell. So we're gonna go through some tough stuff, plus some stuff which will be manageable as well. All right, from our hip rolls, we take it into a little lunge. Step one foot forwards, drop in and push back. We're looking to drop your back knee towards the floor. Push off that front foot. Think about depth in your lunge. Just warming the muscles up, getting everything loose, getting ready for a little workout. Think about a minute and a half left of this warm-up, and then we're straight into our workout, so get the body active. Let's rotate the torso over the front knee. So lunge and twist. Nice and easy. One more to go. All right, bring it into a simple squat for me. Feet turned out slightly. Squat slow, push the knees out, rise back up. Let's go for range of movement. Develop it. We're gonna be coming down here a little later with a real challenge today. Nice and steady. Squat and push. All right, let's speed that up a little. Down, up, down, and up. Bend and push. All right, warming those big muscles up. Starting to bring the heart rate up gently. We're gonna bring this to the floor into a press-up position. Down we go onto hands. Bring the knee up, then step back. So a little step up, keeping the hips strong and stable. Nice and easy. Onto the knees, into press up. We go down, then push. So elbows bending to 90 degrees, coming back on a 45 degree angle. Chest dropping towards the line between your hands. One more of those. Up onto your toes, and a little mountain climb. I'll pick the pace up a little here. So we drive the knee to the chest. Keep it moving. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Stand up and give those legs a little shake. Let's give the arms a big circle. Loosen up, and we're going to get straight into our first round. This is progressive. It's going to feel challenging. You need your kettlebell. And we're going to be doing some single arm work. So this is 30 seconds of work on one side, 3 different moves. Single arm shoulder press is where we're beginning. Tuck the arm in, kettlebell rests on the side of your arm. The single arm shoulder press goes up here and back down. 30 seconds, time is on in 4, 3, 2, 1, off we go. So a single arm press overhead, back to the start point. Now depending on the weight you're using, will be how hard it is. That means if you go lighter, you can do more reps. If it feels challenging, then stick with a nice controlled pace. This is not about how many you do, this is about trying to go for that 30 seconds continuous work. If you want to pick the pace up a little, you can. As long as you can keep the body still, tummy muscles in, we're engaging through here as well as pushing with one arm. Now keeping it in this arm, we're gonna step the opposite leg back. Bring it down, 30 seconds, step back, lunge. This is a reverse lunge, so we're trying to stay stable with the upper body. Abdominals engaged. Tummy muscles strong, back is strong, leg is doing the work. We're trying not to lean forwards too much. We're nice and tall, keep pushing. 15 seconds. Your third exercise is an overhead tricep press. Now, if we can do singles, we'll do singles. If you need to, the option is there for both hands. 2, 1, push it up. We drop it behind the head and then push high. So drop behind and push high. Now we're keeping the upper arm nice and still. Keep your tummy muscles in so we're not arching the back too much, but nice and strong. If you find that too hard, use both hands, bend and push. Depending on the weight you've got, depending on your strength, bend and push. Keep this going. We're nearly there. Bend and push. Feel those triceps start to engage and be challenged. Ready to change arms in two, in one, single arm shoulder press. The clock keeps ticking. So you get the idea. 30 seconds, three exercises, three challenges. Your body should start to feel warm. Using single arm kettlebell work and single leg kettlebell work will always develop that little bit more activation through your core muscles and stability, maximizing your time. Ready to go? In 5 seconds, we lunge. 3, 2, 1. Other leg going back. Let the weight hang. Push off the front foot. Nice and tall. Let's go. So we should start to feel everything start to move. Everything start to feel good. Let's breathe. 15 seconds, and then you've got that single arm tricep push. Let's keep working. Option with the double, remember, if you need it. Deep with the lunge. 5 seconds. Hold the kettlebell however's comfortable when it's overhead. Make sure you're safe. In two, in one, push it up, push it over, bend and push. So you're in control of how you grip it. Make sure it's safe. Make sure the upper arm stays as still as possible. We're bending and we're pushing. We're staying stable. We're working the tricep. Keep it coming. Now, if you need to do the double, do the double. Stay with it. This is the end of round one. There are two rounds. We're going to go straight back in with the tricep push. Sorry, with the shoulder press on the first side. 5 seconds, get ready. 3, 2, 1. Switch it for your shoulder press. All right, let's go. Now we know it. We know this is the last round. We can pump this up and down. If it's feeling light, just get some reps done. But keep your body strong. Keep it still. Ground your feet. Big, strong push overhead. Breathe. Staying with it. 15 seconds to go. Then it's your reverse lunge for the last time this side. Stay with it. All right, we should be feeling good now. Feel the body starting to work. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Stepping back, let's go. Reverse lunge, push. Drive off this foot. Nice and tall with the body. Powerful. If it feels light, use your heavier kettlebell or pump a few more reps out. Let's go. Push them for the last set this side. 15 seconds before that tricep overhead press. Singles if you can. Doubles if you need to. Do what you can do. All right, we've got this. 6 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Pick it up. Push overhead. Tricep extension. Keeping the upper arm still. Bend and push. It's all about that extension, pushing high. That's when the tricep engages. But control it and don't let your body move. Doubles if you need to. Singles if you can. Now it should be burning a little. Starting to work a little. Welcome to your workout. 10 seconds. Then we got one side to go. Shoulder press in 4, in 3, in 2, in 1. Here we go. Shoulders. Shoulder and tricep. Primary movers. Core stability through engaging glutes, abdominals, and staying as still as you can as you drive the kettlebell high and return it to its start point. Make sure you're going for full range of movement. We're pushing high. We're in control. We have 10 seconds to the lunge. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Step it back. All right, let's go. Rep it out. If it's light, then you can move quick. If it's feeling good, you can move quick. If you need a breather, take it. Keep moving. This is a 20-minute workout. We're going straight through. There is very little rest and recovery unless you really need it. Keep the lunge going. Ready for your final tricep extension before the short break and the next three exercises. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Push it up, drop it and push. Let's keep that body still, strong and stable, and then be powerful with your extension. Keep it going. Breathe. All right, should be feeling good, but feeling it. 15 seconds to the break. Stay with it. 10 seconds. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, there was your little break. Breathe. This is now going into single arm swings. Single arm swings, single arm side swings, and then a bicep curl if we can, singles. Depends on the weight, depends on your strength, depends on how you want to do it. A single arm swing is a tip forwards and a swing to chest height. It's only a little knee bend from the side. It's all about that tip of the hips. Swing through, shoulders back. Single arm swing, followed by a single arm side swing, up to shoulder height. Little knee bend is okay in the middle. Okay, control the body, nice and steady, and then bicep curl. Ready? Let's do it, 30 seconds. In three, in two, in one, tip and swing. Let's go. So remember, it is a swing, you're catching that weight. You've got a little knee bend, then we drive the hips. The shoulders are back. Should feel hamstrings engaging. Upper back and shoulder working hard on one side. Hips are square, shoulders are square. 15 seconds, then you've got a real challenge for your side swing. If you've got a lighter kettlebell, you might want to do that for the side swing. If you're stuck with this one, do what you can. 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop it and then swing it. To the side, a little knee bend, swing. We're going for shoulder height only. Nice lat raise, but trying not to lean with the body. Breathe. 30 seconds is gonna feel tough. Then your bicep is gonna burn when you do singles. And if you wanna do doubles, you can. 10 seconds, a little swing, dynamic movement. 4, 3, 2, 1. Let it stop, then curl it up and down. This is all about full range of movement. And it's about keeping your torso still and not letting your body swing. If you need to do doubles, grab hold and do doubles. Otherwise, single curl, up and down, breathe. Do what you can to get through the next 10 seconds. And then it's a single arm swing the other side. Ready to go? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 30 seconds, tip and swing. Let that arm relax. It's tough work, single arms. All right, we should be in the middle now. Tip and push the hips forward. Drive those hips, it's a dynamic, explosive exercise. This is where you really focus on technique. Little knee bend, drive with the hips, drive with the legs. Swing and control with the upper back and the torso. Stay with it, 6 seconds. Then your side swing for shoulder strength. 2, 1, let it stop. Side swing, go. Easy. Find your swing rhythm. Find that little knee bend. Height, level with your own chest. Not too high, don't let the body lean. Just a little bounce is good. That little knee bend will help absorb it at the bottom. It's 15 seconds more. Stay with it. Keep coming, and then you've got your bicep curl. Hang in there. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let it stop. Curl. Now focus on keeping the body still. Tummy muscles in. We're keeping that upper arm fixed. So we're curling up, and we're trying not to move the elbow forwards here. We keep it still and we curl up and release down with control. Control bicep. You know the drill. We do 2 rounds. Round 1 is nearly over. 5 seconds and then we're back with this hand swinging. In 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. Tip and swing. Get those legs involved. Tip, push. Should be getting a little warm, a little sweat on, a little workout. Hey, even with an 8 kilo kettlebell, you can build muscular strength and endurance. You can get a workout in 20 minutes, guys. You are doing it. Let's work through it. Stay strong. All right, nice and powerful with your swing. Ready for the side swing. In 3, in 2, in 1. Let it stop. Off we go, swing to the side. 30 second challenge. Final time on this side. Work through it. Breathe. You won't believe how far you're into this workout. Let's get through it. Let's work this level. Little knee bend, push. Stay strong, 10 seconds. Ready for your bicep curl. Stay with it. 3, 2, 1. Bicep curl time. Move with control. Power is nothing without control. So lift and lower. Do the doubles if you need to. Remember, options are there for you. Rest and shake it out anytime you need to. Final time on this side. Oh, now we're feeling it. Woo. 10 seconds to go. Feel that burn. Dig deep. 6, four, three, two, one. Let's go, light swing. All right, control it. Your body gets a little tired. We focus on technique. Tip and swing. Little knee bend. Flick the hips, shoulder back. Up to chest height only for these swings today. Pushing with your feet into the ground. We're looking good, we're doing well. We're feeling strong. That's what it's all about. 10 seconds to the side swing. Hang in there. Four, three, two, one. Let it stop. Swing it to the side. Let's go. 20 minutes, guys. You're nearly there. Second set of these. Little knee bend if you need it. Make it a swing, not a lift. It's dynamic. Control on the way down. Power on the way up. 10 seconds to go. Ready for your bicep curl. Final time on this side. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Let it stop. Bicep go. Breathe. Keep your body still. This is now strength and stability. The challenge. Stay with it. Breathe. All right. Strong to the finish. 15 seconds to your little break. Stay with it. Less than 10. Hang in there. You're going to get a little break. I'll give it you. Four, three, two, one. Put it down safe. Shake it out. Woo. All right. Yeah, sweaty. We're warm. We're working. 20-minute workout. You're nearly done. You've got a few extra challenges to do yet, though. Still 30 seconds, but only two exercises now. But there are three sets instead of two. Give and take. Okay. This is your two exercises here. We're going to hold the kettlebell with your thumbs through. We're going to go round the head and then back the other way. The idea is to get a big circle right round close to your head. So we're mobilizing shoulders. I want you to lean, let your body lean a little bit. So we activate obliques as well, but keep your hips still. Look at my legs, look at my hips. They stay still. That's exercise one for 30 seconds. Exercise two, option one, same grip. Squat, then press right over your head, head through the gap. That's option one. Option two, squat, press, release, then push up. That's much harder, depends on your shoulder strength and your mobility. Have a go if you think you can do it or you know you can do it. Otherwise, stick with option one. I'll be showing you again, get ready. 10 seconds and we're in. Around the world, take it close to the back of the head. Thumbs through, you need a fairly light weight for this one. Ready, 30 seconds. Three, two, one. Grind your feet, roll. Let your body move, there's different ways of doing this. Today we are rolling around the back of the head for shoulder mobility. And we're letting the body move side to side for a little oblique action as well. So abdominals, shoulders, doing the work. Don't grip it too tight, but be safe with your kettlebell. Hey, there's only 10 seconds to go. Then I'll show you option one again and option two. 5 seconds, three, two, one. Option one, we squat and we push. We squat and we push. Option two, squat, push, return, stand. Squat, push, return. It's hard. Stand. Do what you can. Make your challenge right for you. 15 seconds to go. Option one, remember, is down, then push on the way up. 10 seconds. Do your movement. Your workout. Four, three, two, one. Guess what? No break. Shoulders are going to be on fire. Arms are going to feel it. Heart rate is going to be up. You came for a workout. You're following along, which means I'm doing it and you're doing it. So let's finish it strong. Breathe. We're working it. We're doing well. We have 8 seconds. Then option one or two. Ground those feet, look. Hips are staying still. Torso is moving. Two, one. Option one, squat and press. Option two, squat, then press, then return. Go again if you can. Remember, doesn't matter how many you do, it's about quality over quantity. Breathe. Working hard, pushing for 10 seconds. Stay with it. Five, four, three, two, one more. Oh yes, now we feel it. Shoulders on fire. Rest if you need, work if you can. Around the world, close to the back of the head. Drop that kettlebell out of sight. You're nearly there, you've got 10 seconds. Then option one or two, work it. I'm gonna show you both again. 5, 4, 3, 2. One more time, let's go. Squat and press, or the option two. Squat, then press, then release, then stand. Woo! Oh yeah, it feels good, round three. Shoulders, back, legs, everything working hard to stabilize, to power, to push. 10 seconds. Stay with it. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. One more. 1. Relax. Kettlebell down. Shake. You're nearly there. Last couple of minutes. Come on, dig deep. 20 minute workout nearly done. We're lying down. We've got two exercises. Have a look. We have the kettlebell. Reach overhead. Knees are bent. Overhead touch the floor. Lift up, push over the knees to make it easier to sit up. Control on the way down. Have the kettlebell closer to you to make it harder. Exercise two, seated twist. Leaning back, but not rounding the back. Be tall and lean. 30 seconds of each. Three times through, ready. 4, 3, 2, 1. Down we go with control. Overhead touch, sit up. Push over the knees to help you sit all the way up. Control on the way down. It's not about how many you do. What did I just say? Quality over quantity. Feel your abdominals working. Kettlebell closer to you will make it harder to sit up. Find that level that challenges you. Push over the knees if you need to help. Let's work through it. Nearly there. 6 seconds and then we twist. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold that kettlebell. Touch it down if you can. I want you to go around as far as you can go with this twist. Knees are bent, leaning back a little. It's not about how quick you go. If you need to do it without the kettlebell, if the arms are too tired and you can rotate more, then do it without. But if you can, use the kettlebell. 10 seconds. Come on, these are my last two exercises. We've done one round, we've got two to go. In 4, in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Down, touch, lift. With control. Keep that kettlebell close to your chest to make it harder. Breathe as you curl. Nicely done. Let's work through this 30 seconds of effort. Lift it. All right, we are fast approaching our 20 minutes of actual work. With that warm-up and a cool-down, you've nailed it. Inside 30 minutes, full workout and a stretch. Ready to twist in 2, in 1. Here we go, twists, move it. Round to the side for round 2. 30 seconds on the clock. Keep moving, keep twisting. Stay strong, we have this. In the back, 15 seconds. I want you to work to the end of this session. Challenge yourself like you have done for the whole 20 minutes. 5 to go, 4, 3, 2. One more set, what can you do? Lower down with control. Curl up with control. Breathe, do it again. Lower down with control. Touch, curl with control, lift. Breathe, 15 seconds, and then you are in it for the final 30. The little twist to finish is all you've got to do. Stay with it, 6 seconds. Get one more curl in. 4, 3, 2, 1, seated twist to finish. 30 seconds of your session left. Let's work through it. All right, stay strong, good technique. Let your head follow your hands. Torso rotating. Stay strong, 15 seconds to go. Last 10. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Job done. Woo! Now you should have felt that all over. You should be as warm and as sweaty as I am. Woo. Tough one. We're gonna have a little stretch just to loosen up some of those muscles that worked hard. So I want you to reach nice and high. Circle your arms. Do it again. Big reach. 20 minutes of work, a few minutes of stretching and warming up. That is all you need for this workout. Squeeze those shoulders back, breathe. Feet come together, we're gonna fold gently. Knees bent if you need, chest over, arms over, sink in. Gently release. Take one foot. So a lot of that focus was single arm work, was about stability. Kettlebells should be used as much as you can, single arm, to challenge stability, maximize your workout. There's loads of ways to train, loads of good kettlebell classes and sessions out there. I hope this one gives you a little inspiration, a little something to try. Give those legs a shake, give yourselves a high five, and I'll see you on the next one. Well done.